Let us all stand together and sing page 212, O Come All Ye Faithful.
Celebration of worship. couple of things for you to know this evening. You should have been given a candle when you came in. We're going to use those later on in the service. And so people will come to the ends of your pew to light your candle, and you can just light them along the pew, the length of the pew, as we sing our last song, Silent Night. Our offering tonight, you can leave it at the exit there, or this way, whichever way you came in. The offering tonight, we are dividing between Crossroads Community Center in Philadelphia and Ripple Congregation in Allentown. They are both in the middle of building programs, and so this is our way to support them in their building program. This is from the book of Hebrews in the very first chapter. In the past, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets at many times and in various ways. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things and through whom he also made the universe. The Son is the radiance of God's glory and the exact representation of his being, sustaining all things by his powerful word. So we know that God has been speaking to humanity, speaking to the creation all through the history of the world, and the writer of Hebrews says that the very last thing that God says to the world, that God says to the creation, is when God speaks in the person of Jesus. And so I want you to think tonight about what it is in Jesus that God is saying to you. And God is saying to you tonight, saying to the whole creation in Jesus, that you are loved. You are loved just exactly as you find yourself to be. This could have been a really great year for you that is coming to a close, or this could have been an incredibly difficult year for you that is coming to a close. Wherever you find yourself to be, whatever your circumstances are like, what God is saying to you in Jesus is that you are loved, that you are God's child, that you are precious, that you are valuable. And so as we sing together tonight, as we worship together tonight, let that thought just rest with you, that you are a beloved child of God, and that you know that because of what God has done for you in Jesus. Amen.
Let's stand. Number 199, and we will do verses 1, 2, and 4.
as recorded in Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared, with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Two songs to sing, and I'm going to ask you to stand, because as the program goes on, you will be doing quite some sitting. So would you stand to sing 197, "Angels We Have Heard on High," and I'd like to hear the ladies sing the second verse, the men sing the third verse, and we all sing the choruses together. Second verse, ladies, third verse, men.
Oh,
So tonight, we want you to go back in time with us. About 80 or 90 years ago, nobody was streaming anything. Nobody was even watching television. But every evening around the world, millions of people would gather around their radios. And they would listen to different stories that were told, and they would use their imagination to see what things looked like. And so tonight, we have an old-time radio show that was written for us by Emily Rush. And we are going to be interweaving that with the performances from the choir.
Good evening, folks. Thanks for tuning in to this special program. I'm Tunia Dial, and I'm really excited for our show this evening. Now, you may be aware of some significant happenings in our town last evening. There have been a number of rumors, speculations, and quite frankly, wild stories. From a shining star to unexpected visitors to a miraculous birth. Now, there doesn't seem to be many specifics just yet, but it's my job to get you some answers tonight, and that is exactly what this radio report is going to do. All of us have been especially busy lately, traveling for the census, dealing with Roman rule, just living life from day to day. But that won't just stop us here at WJCM Bethlehem. For us, getting the news and the truth to you is our top priority. Stay tuned for this interview on location after this song from our WJCM studio choir that will take us to the far reaches of the Roman Empire. Describe it to you, our radio listeners, but honestly, it's just a basic inn, like so many others. Let's find out what's so special about this one. To start, we're going to talk to the owner of this establishment. Let's see what we can find out.
Hello, hello. Welcome. It's an honor to have you here.
I'm happy to be here. Thanks for agreeing on such short notice. I'm excited to learn about what's been happening here.
Let me show you around. I'm proud to say this inn has been in my family for generations. We have a fine establishment here, fine as any in Bethlehem, perfect location, right off the main road.
Yes, I found it very easily.
Exactly. And as you can see, we have three spacious rooms with plenty of floor space to lay out. We can accommodate families or whole caravans.
Well, I heard one particular family had an interesting...
Did you know that Caesar's first attendant's cousin's brother stayed here in this very house?
No, I didn't know that. But there was a different special guest just recently.
And through there, in the kitchen, where my wife is wrapping up from the dinner rush, be sure you try her challah, fresh out of the oven, exquisite. We've gotten stellar reviews.
Yes, it smells wonderful. But what I'm really here for, and what my listeners are dying to know, are about the strange events from the other night.
Are you sure you wouldn't rather see the courtyard?
Not right now.
All right. As you know, it's a busy time right now with the census and all. Weary travelers everywhere you turn. Good business for inns. And having a prime location, three spacious rooms, a pleasant courtyard.
Your wife's challah.
Exactly. And my wife's challah. We were brimming with well-provided for guests.
Well, you are an excellent host. There's no doubt about that.
I'm glad you said that. Keep that in mind for this next bit. The night had grown late, and our rooms were full when there was another tired knock on the door.
So what did you do, being the excellent host that you are?
Well, I answered the door, ready to give a profuse apology and as best help as I could give, when I saw a sight that pulled at my heartstrings.
What was there?
A man, bone tired and worried, and behind him his wife, fit to bursting with child.
What did you do?
As you know, I simply had no room, but I couldn't turn them away. I pride myself on hospitality. The very pregnant woman arrived on an equally tired donkey, which gave me an idea. I led them back to our stable. As a host, it makes me shudder. Normally, I would never take our guests to the stable. Well, that's just not the kind of inn I operate. I hope your listeners appreciate the impossible situation.
I am sure they do.
Even in the stable, I made them as comfortable as I could. Fresh straw, blankets, water. But ultimately, they wanted privacy. And as an understanding host, I respect that.
So when did you realize something special was happening?
Special? I don't know about special. What I do know is eventually more people started showing up, not for my inn, not to stop and rest, not even for my wife's challah, but they came to see this child born. Even with the census, I have never had such traffic here.
Incredible.
I know, a perfectly good inn, and they walked back to the stable. Didn't even come in when I offered. All they wanted to know was where the Christ child was born. I just don't understand some people. And they were a ragtag group of shepherds, if that tells you anything. Not the most social, you know, not my clientele.
And doesn't that show you how important this child is?
Important? When Caesar's first attendant's cousin's brother comes to see this baby, then I might call it important. For now, it's just an interesting event that, I can't lie, I'm happy is giving us publicity. My marketing folks are delighted.
Well, do you have any other thoughts on last night?
I want your listeners to know this was a once-in-a-lifetime occurrence.
A miracle, some might say.
Sure, I guess. And then I suppose every birth is. But I just want them to know, if you come to our inn, we'll have a space for you, certain. There's a piece of challah with your name on it.
Of course. Thank you for your time. And we're actually going to have a word with that lauded baker after my listeners take a trip to the far islands of the Roman Empire. Stay tuned after the song. Just lovely folks. A big thanks to our WJCM Bethlehem Studio Choir. Well, we're now in the humble kitchen of the inn, a fire crackling along the wall, plates and dishes being washed, baskets with the leftovers of the day, a bustling hub of hospitality. We are here with the innkeeper's wife, Rachel. Now, I've already heard great things about your challah, Rachel.
Well, my husband is sweet, but he likes to upsell, well, everything.
Oh, I'm sure.
Don't worry, my challah is great. I just don't want you getting the idea that this is a five-star resort hotel.
You have a lovely establishment.
That we do. An establishment built by this family and sustained by hard work. Speaking of work, you don't mind if I wash up while we talk, do you?
Of course not. Go ahead.
As I'm sure my husband pointed out, it's a busy time for us. Visitors from out of town to take care of, food to make, rooms to clean, always something to do.
In all of this busyness, were you able to catch the miracle last night?
Miracle? It's a miracle that mother made it here and put up with everything else going on around her.
Did you speak with her then? Share some maternal wisdom with her?
She was so young. I can't imagine carrying that weight and coming here, traveling all this way. If I had... I did see her briefly. I brought them more blankets and more water as the night went on. I didn't want to encroach, you know. If it had been anyone else, I think my heart would have broken.
Well, why didn't it?
Her face.
Her face?
It had such joy. She was exhausted, and well, she had just had a baby. But when she looked at him, it was like...
Like what?
Like she knew something the rest of us didn't. Something that made the travel and the tiredness, even the animals around her, not that bad. I checked on them one last time that night, after the crowds and shepherds had left. Pausing at the door, I watched her, just for a minute. Her husband was asleep, but she was still awake, cradling the infant. And as I watched, it was like she held all the love of the world in her arms.
That's a powerful image.
It's silly. Here you are, listening to me prattle on. Is there anything else you wanted to know?
Is there anything else you want to say?
I didn't see them that often. I had so much to do that night. I still have so much to do. It's a busy season, you know? I haven't had time to stop and talk with every traveler along the way. I barely have time to talk to an interviewer.
Of course. Thank you so much for your time, Rachel. I'll let you get back to your work. And I'll let our listeners have another chance to hear our WJCM choir take us to the southern hills of Bethlehem.
Thank you.
sound our choir makes. Thank you for that lovely song. Well, listeners, I'm standing outside the stable where it all happened. A child born right here amidst the bustle and busyness of this season. A night to remember for that family, to be sure, though the world keeps going. It seems like the world, or at least this innkeeper's family, is ready to move on.
What are you talking about?
Well, hello there. I'm just talking to my listeners here about the events of last night. Did you know a little baby was born here last night?
Yeah, I live here.
Oh, my folks, listeners, we have one more witness to talk to. Well, you've had quite the excitement here, haven't you?
Sure we have. But what were you saying about us being ready to move on? My family isn't moving.
Well, I've already talked to your mommy and your daddy, who seem to be ready to get back to work. That's what I meant by moving on.
You don't seem to understand.
Understand what?
Last night was amazing. We don't just move on from this. This is what we've been waiting for.
What who's been waiting for?
All of us. You, me, the whole world has been waiting. The readings in the synagogue, they've all been pointing here. Why do you think so many people showed up already last night? In fact, you're kind of late.
Well, I got here as soon as I could get my crew together.
Haven't you heard what they're calling him?
I mean, I did hear a bit, but...
Come in here.
Oh, okay, folks, we're headed to the stable, the place itself.
There. Do you feel it?
A simple stable. The straw strewn around the floor, the animals, the smells. You almost can't tell that anything special happened here last night.
Stop talking. Just be here. It's all the love in the world.
What?
The people who were here last night, I heard them. They called him the Messiah, the Christ child, the Son of God. Born here. Poor, small, dirty, but with all the power in the world in him. Do you know what I think?
Who's the interviewer here?
I think he came for you, and he came for me. And I know that because he came here, to the straw and the dirt and the cold, in the lowest and smelliest of places, to this place of nowhere and everywhere. Not for what we'll get out of it, but for you and for me, for everyone.
For everyone. Wow. How old are you anyway?
I'll be 10 next year.
So you're 9?
Almost 10.
Well, from the mouths of babes. Folks, I think my new friend here may have just pointed out the most important part of this story, a part I would have missed if I hadn't been encouraged to just stop and notice. Well, listeners, we are just about out of time here. I have some things to think about, and I suspect you, my listeners, might too. I will leave you with this scene, a simple stable amidst the bustle of the world, a place to stop, take a breath, feel all the love in the world, and know that all is well. And so to close out our program today, we have one last song. This is Tunia Dial, signing off from the stable in Bethlehem.
is well. As Pastor Michael said, God spoke his final word in Jesus, letting us know that he is a God who fulfills his promises, his promise to draw us all back into his kingdom through his Son. As we light our candles tonight, I just want to make sure to remind you that once your candle is lit, you hold it straight and the person who's going to light theirs from your light bends their candle. I think that's all. So I'll invite the candle lighters to come.
Oh,
stand, please. So go from this place to rest in the knowledge that love has come in Jesus. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.